on how to move this forward, especially to reduce to improve maternal health. The other thing I wanted to add is the SDGs and how important they are to health. And you remember recently we had agreed with the UN community that as a country or as governors, we are the ones expected to ensure that SDGs work and are implemented. We must, as a matter of priority, as we look at the health policies, incorporate within our budgets, incorporate those things that we must do to improve SDGs as we move forward in this area. Now, there are two other things I need to make a comment on. Immunization budget is a matter that we had agreed as a council that we will leave to the national government. We are finding that it was a serious mistake we made as a council, that we let this out to the national government. It is something that we are in fact doing. And if you had Catherine Muma talk about monies being sent to coordinators in the pockets, they send as much as 7 million to an individual's account to do immunization. Now, this is something we can clearly do, and we should in fact insist that it should be brought back, because the purchase is being done at a level where we all go at KEMSA institution. They can control it there. We have fridges, we have everything that it is required to implement this strategy. We will insist on an agreement on what the national government will do and what we must do. I know we left it to them, but I think it is an area where we must now review to make sure that we change in that area. Now, when I talked about starting on a bumpy ride, there is this issue of leased equipment. And I have had consistently two of our colleagues being vilified, Governor Munya, who is the chair of the COG, and Governor Ruto, who is chairman emeritus. Now, today I can stand to say that these are the stalwarts of devolution, and I think I need an applause in that area. Because it is not, they had bought the equipment anyway. There was no need for anyone of us to put a signature. They knew the law, and they still violated the law. What our colleagues stood for, he said, you brought it, you continue with it, you don't need my signature. And I think they were true to devolution, and that's why I wanted to make this statement here, so that they also know that we are behind them in whatever they stood to do, even though we failed on our part to do what we should have done as governors, because it wasn't clear. They were pitching us against the public, and of course it depended on the area, on the environment of each one of us. So you looked at it and said, okay, let me put a signature, because it may appear that I'm working against my own people. So I want to take this opportunity to congratulate those two governors for standing out for the truth. Then there are certain issues that came from the floor, the public sector issue that we are pursuing for staff cadres across the county and national government. And this, I think, is work in progress. It is still being done. I am happy that there is progress in this area under Governor Ongwae. The final thing I want to add is that as a council, what we are doing is working closely with the research institutions, KEMRI, CDC, and others. What we have seen that has been lacking in the past is that we have preeminent research institutions in the country, but we have not made use of them as a country to tell us why are people dying of this or of that, or what causes death, and how can we reduce the incidences. And this they have agreed to do gladly, and very soon we will sign a memorandum of an understanding between the COG and KEMRI, CDC, and other research institutions, so that as we provide health as a service, it will be a service of quality. I want to take this opportunity to thank all the presenters at the plenary, and also the audience for giving us the thoughts and for your ideas. We believe that this will help us endear or to strengthen health as a service to the people of Kenya. I hand over to the conference moderator. The panelists, and especially to the moderator.
Thank you very much. I think we've had a very interesting session, so I'd like the panel to go down as we appreciate them again. I think they've really gone on with a conversation that started yesterday on very critical issues in devolution. And just to point out, there were certain issues that were raised for the Cabinet Secretary for Health. He will be joining us, and we're going to have him respond to those issues. As we go on, I'd like us to recognize the presence of the members of county assemblies. So if the members of the county assembly from the northeastern region would stand up so that people acknowledge and appreciate their presence. If we can have the MCAs from Nyanza stand up so that we appreciate them. Members from the coast region. Members from the coast region, please appreciate them. Members from eastern region, if we don't appreciate them, they may send us away or we may not have our way home. Please appreciate them. Members from western, please stand up so that I saw some registering yesterday. Members from the Rift Valley, please stand up. Members from Central Region, please stand up. And finally, the members from Nairobi, please stand up. Thank you. I had Professor Kibwana identify himself as a doctor, and I think now as we move to the next session, we may all want to identify ourselves as farmers. Because I thought he was a professor, but he said he's a doctor, and we were talking about health. So we are now going to move to the next session, and that session is going to be chaired by Governor Okoth Obado, if he can come up to the front. Then we will have it moderated by Professor Margaret Kamar, if she can come forward. We will have a statement in this session issued by Mr. Willie Bett, who's the Cabinet Secretary for Agriculture, and if he can come up as well. We have the main speaker here being Mr. Stanley Bagathi, who is the CADOP facilitator. He'll tell us what CADOP is. And then we have panelists, Governor John Nyagarama, Governor Patrick Haemba, Mr. Robert Allport, and Professor Wanjiku Kabira. If you can come up, please. Please remember the rules that people who give statements, 7 minutes, and the panelists will intervene for 2 minutes, so that we also engage the floor and so that we also come back to the panelists, the statement giver, and the speaker. Governor Obado, you have the floor.
Okay. Dear participants, I take this opportunity to welcome all of you to this plenum four, where we are going to look at the progress on devolved functions and interventions for emerging challenges. The objective is to deliberate on the progress made in the performance of key devolved functions and how the challenges so far identified can be addressed. So, before we proceed, allow me to do a brief introduction. My name is Okoth Obado, Governor Migori County. That is county code number 44. And it is found on the western part of the country. I pride myself as the only county that borders two international boundaries, that is both Tanzania and Uganda. Now with me here are a series of experts in the field we are going to discuss today, and that is agriculture. I have Professor Margaret Kamar, who will be moderating the session. And I would like to take this opportunity to give Professor also a brief moment to introduce to us the panelists that we'll be having here. Karib.
Thank you very much, Chair. Before us, we are going to have a speaker, Stanley Mbakathi. Please wave. He is going to go forward to do a presentation of the paper. And we will be followed thereafter by Willie Bate, the CS, so that the statements on policy come out before we debate. Willie Bate, the CS, is here with us. Then we have two of our governors from the grain basket of the nation. We have Governor Jackson Mandago from Uasin Gishu and Governor Patrick Kaemba from Trans Nzoia. Then we have Governor John Nyagarama from Kisii.
Nyamira.
The land of matoke and bananas. Yeah. And we were expecting the senator to be with us. We are informed that he's not arrived yet. We will have Robert Alpop. Welcome. And we'll have Professor Wanjigo Kapira.
Oh, okay.
Welcome.
Thank you very much, Professor. Now, distinguished participants, we are going to talk about a very, very important sector, a sector that employs in Kenya here directly and indirectly over 85% of the workforce. We are going to talk about a sector that is fully devolved and a sector that I believe all the counties have also fully embraced and are ready to count their successes based on it. For us in Kenya, I'm happy to report that if we have to effectively handle the sustainable development goals, like goal number one and goal number two, then this is the sector to give serious attention to. I would like also, ladies and gentlemen, to give my very, very brief account about the sector. First, I'm a farmer, and I've been representing farmers in various fora. At one time, and for several years, I was a director at the Kenya Sugar Board. I also got an opportunity to become a chairman of the Kenya Sugar Board. And I'm always proud to say that I owe my current position to that kind of trust that the farmers bestowed on me. And I would like that trust still to be kept on. If you look around in the countryside, you will see a lot of transformations that the sector has done on the lives of the people. We do it on a daily basis because of what we produce from our farms. So indeed, this is a very, very critical sector for all of us. For any living creature, I think agriculture is key. So I want to welcome you. I want to invite all of you to intellectually participate in this session, and I expect that by the end of the session, most of your questions, the issues, will have been addressed. Here with us, we have experts in this field, but I know where you are seated, you are also an expert on your own. So fully participate in this one here, even the people who are seated at the back, I want to invite you. And we are going to follow very, very simple rules. The speaker, for example, I will give the speaker at most 7 minutes. The other panelists, I think for the sake of time, I will give them not more than 2 minutes so that we complete the session very, very fast. And without wasting time, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to invite the session speaker, Mr. Stanley Mbagathi, just to start us off. Karibu.
Thank you, Chair, esteemed members on the panel, my dear Kenyan farmers, livestock keepers, fisher folk. I think that takes care of most of you, you've been recognized, and other ladies and gentlemen. Of course, I recognize the presence of the CSS. I recognize the presence of the governance. Now, mine is a simple task, just to set you off to discuss agriculture. And I said you are mostly, all of you are farmers, so this is something that is close to your hearts. Back in 2003, Kenya was involved in the design of CADAP. CADAP, as the convener said, is an African initiative to promote agriculture. It's called the Comprehensive African Agriculture Program. The CADAP is supposed to help member states, African member states of AUC, with the leadership of NEPAD, to push agriculture and transform the continent, because it's been recognized that agriculture is the biggest driver of economic growth and which can lead to alleviating most of our woes, hunger and poverty and so forth. So we signed up to CADAP in 2003. Last year, in 2014, we were also in Malabo and we were involved in the revitalization of agriculture. And one of the key aspects of CADAP is that we have all committed to spending at least 10% of our budgets on agriculture, the national budgets on agriculture. And that, of course, means also the county budgets should be similar. We should be spending at least 10% on agriculture, and we have committed to that. Now, the unfortunate thing, and what I don't understand, is how you can make such a commitment, and then after that, you go on and do exactly the opposite. Since 2010, the budget allocated to agriculture has dropped from 4.7% to around 3% in 2014-15. So we are obviously not keeping our commitment to CADAP. But all is not lost. Let me have a small presentation to show you what I think about what's going on in the sector. If my colleague can send, I don't know whether it's up. It's difficult not knowing what you are. It's on. So I'm assuming the slide on there. Let me have a look. Yeah, the slide is talking about four studies which have been carried out in the last few months. In less than a year, Kenya has carried out at least four studies. And these studies have been on the agriculture sector. And the studies have come up with similar findings. There has been a study through the AUC itself, looking at the joint sector review to see how are we doing in agriculture. Are we following the CADAP process, which is a consultative, inclusive process? Are we involving all the stakeholders? Are we involving the private sector? So there was a study called the JSR, which was done by RESAX, those who know it. And apart from that, there has also been another study funded by USAID and Africa and the Minister of Agriculture, looking at the institutional setup in agriculture. Since devolution, of course, the situation has changed, and the setup, institutional setup has changed. Then there was this one on enabling environment by FAO, followed also another one by on coordination. Now, has it gone to the next? Ikosawa, tuko wapi? Number three, number two. The one is on introduction. Yes, I said they found similar findings. They got similar findings. The similar findings, I can put them in six areas. And these are areas related to want us to move at the same rate, and I have very few minutes. The area is agriculture sector challenges, is what you're having? Is that what you have on the screen? Yeah, agriculture sector challenges is an undefined framework for policy development and reform process. We found out that although we know that the policy formulation process is a national government function, it is not being done through a clear procedure, which says this is where it should, a process to be formed, this is where it should start, this is where it should end, this is how it should be done, in short. Apart from that, the counties are also making policies, all kinds of policies, although it is not their function. So there is an unclear process of policy reform, which has created quite a bit of confusion. The national government is making more and more policies because that is their function, and they are doing it without necessary consultation. But I must say, for the agriculture sector, now we have an overarching policy which has been looked at by stakeholders, and I'm almost sure that it will be approved, and that can then guide the policy making also at the county's level. The other area is inadequate sector coordination. The coordination in the sector has been a big trouble. There are so many coordinators, all kinds of coordinators, coordinating all kinds of people. We do not have a structure like we used to have of ASDS, you know it, with ASCU, where we had the Agriculture Sector Coordination Unit, which was leading in coordinating other stakeholders in what we are calling thematic working groups, working together to in the process of finding areas and consulting between CSOs, private sector, and government. That has not taken place, and therefore there's confusion. In the counties which were ASAL, there are what you call county steering groups. But that is not in all counties. And they are also, their mandate is not the sector coordination. So we have a big issue here. There is limited inclusivity. You ask the private sector, they will tell you they haven't been adequately involved. We could talk about this for a long time. The same with the CSOs. To go faster, let me talk about one of the areas where I feel it's a major area and we need to look at it, because decisions are being made without adequate backing or evidence. We don't use enough data. We make decisions without data. That is why when you also don't have consultative processes, when you don't involve the experts, then you make decisions which are not valid. The area of lack of use of data is a major issue. Of course, the funding, it has been talked about. You'll talk about it more. I'm sure that is clear. It is a major issue. Money is being retained elsewhere and not going where it is supposed to be. And the last one I would like to talk is about also the role of the supporters, like the donor, the donors, the development partners. They are supposed to work in a way that is also clear, that one knows how do you contact them, where are they, what they should be doing. They used to have a code of conduct. That code of conduct seems to have been forgotten. So donors are also doing their own thing, and that is not good for us. So this is one area I could say these are key challenges. But let me move on. Yes, we have. You have in front of you some recommendations toward the first issue I mentioned about policy. There are too many policies. If I show you the hierarchy of policies, the picture next is about hierarchy. There are so many, I'll not go through them. We shows you from the top and in the middle, the actual sector policy. And below, you have the sectoral policies, you have the commodity policies, and even you have now counties making policies. Then you have strategic plans and programs. It's a big world. But this world is not adequately organized. So we are saying we should refrain from making too many policies, and we should collapse some of them so that we have a clear field. We should rationalize the formulation process so that everybody knows their role. And other counties, we should develop county strategies. I hardly came across counties which have got their agriculture sector strategy. They should develop their county agriculture sector strategies, which are linked to the overall agriculture, livestock, and fisheries policy, which I hear is almost done. So you should make sure that your strategies are linked to that policy, so we don't have a confusion, but we have some clear ways of doing things. Those strategies then should guide you in making your strategic plans. And the strategic plans will be the source or the basis for your budgets. Now you know the budgeting process is based on the CIDPs, which you know hasn't got the quality that you would like to have. We have also there issues in terms of what are the documents that we are using. So the policy, the strategies, and the strategic plans with proper budgets approved by your MCAs, who should not be just destroying what has been done by experts, but actually being more professional, then we may have a better situation. I have also said that we should establish a CADAP. We talked about CADAP. CADAP now is not a property of the national government. It is a stakeholder process. So it should be actually also established. And our suggestion is that it should be established at the Intergovernmental Secretariat for Agriculture. The Intergovernmental Secretariat for Agriculture has already been formed. It has been populated by county staff and also by national staff. This is a big step forward. So let's go to the next slide. I believe this is on sector coordination. We are saying there should be a credible and inclusive coordination structure with similar entities. I talked earlier about the thematic working groups. We should form thematic work groups which are similar to what has been formed at the AIGS. We have thematic groups on monitoring and evaluation and communication. We have working groups on nutrition, capacity building, and so forth. We want to form structures that speak to each other. We also need to have at the IGS, because this should be a place where these come together, and we are saying it should be at the intergovernmental, agriculture intergovernmental secretariat, with the national government having its thematic working groups, which are multi-stakeholder, including the private sector and so forth, the counties having theirs, which are also multi-stakeholder, and all linked to the IGS, and all being inclusive in their own areas. So that is one of the big issues that need to be established and needs to be discussed and agreed on.
Mr. Speaker, one more minute.
Only one. Let me see now how fast I can go. I said we establish an MNE system, also a SAX node is a knowledge node which will give you data for use in planning and so forth and running the sector. Let's have the next slide, which is now slide. It's the one with the tables. Yeah, that already I mentioned earlier, the funding to the sector has declined. It's less than in other sectors, and it is, if you want, has declined from 2010, and it continues to decline. That hopefully will change. So, but there is hope. Let's go to the next slide. Let's talk about hope. Let's not talk about doom. Is there a slide on hope? He has another one. I'll talk about hope afterwards. Let me talk about the allocation to the counties. It's also clear. I have shown there that the counties are not giving enough to agriculture equally. There are some counties which are doing very well, like Kwale, like Tharaka Nithi, and so forth. And then there are counties which are giving very little, like Kiambu, Nyandarua, and so forth, and all the others in between. I have the first five there and the last five down there. They are all more or less than 10%. So they are not keeping to the CADA process. So let's go to the next slide, and let me talk about the hope. And my hope is that with proper systems, coherent policies, inclusive coordination, approaches that based on, for example, I've been cut off. I'm still on. Yeah, with good approaches, good governance, evidence-based decision-making, mutual accountability procedures, smart use of technology, and this is very important. Smart use of technology, for example, improved breeds and varieties, soil and water management, using smart mechanization like conservation agriculture, well-designed irrigation schemes and water management schemes. Talk about facilitative market systems, infrastructure, tax regimes, post-harvest storage, warehouse receipt systems, which are almost now being accepted generally, value addition, staff capacity, credible extension systems, like in the county, you give up the home economics position, reinstall the home economics position because we need it for nutrition. We can be self-sufficient within 10 years in food and achieve the goal of CADAP and sustainable development goals of eradicating hunger by 2025. Let me finish with one quotation from the CEO of NEPA talking just last week in Accra during the 12th CADAP partnership platform. And he said, as a continent, we must demonstrate how proactive we are in injecting our own resources in agriculture. And I leave it there. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much, Bwana Speaker. Now, ladies and gentlemen, with your permission, and also given the sensitivity of the matter, both nationally and globally, kindly allow me to give the CS for Agriculture just a few minutes also to address this distinguished gathering.
Chairman of the session, Chairman COG, and whom I believe are farmers who have come here today, let me take this opportunity before my time clock starts to tick to bring a small apology from my colleague, that is the Minister for Health. I was supposed to come with him in the morning, but the minutes we were supposed to take actually failed to take off. I find this very important because he was determined from last night we were coming together. But because his session was appearing before mine, and because the means had failed, me, I could make it on road. So I started hitting the road, and he could not make it because his time was supposed to come before mine. But if he has decided to come and answer other questions, that would be welcomed. But I really wanted to apologize for him because we were ready to come together up to midnight, yes, before we received the bad news. Now, my time should start ticking from now. We are all in agreement, and I want to thank and congratulate my brother Mbakati for bringing out some of the issues I was supposed to bring out in terms of the challenges in the sector and some of the proposals what we need to do to ensure that the sector really moves forward. What I would want to do is just to emphasize the importance of this sector and the need to coordinate it with the county governments to ensure that we move this sector forward. Since I joined the ministry very recently, I realized a lot had happened in terms of coordination. What is happening is that from the Ministry of Agriculture, a very strong intergovernmental unit has been established. And I know Mbakati mentioned it, but I really need to emphasize, because of the many challenges which came with devolution, and of which we all need to accept that as a new way of doing business, it was not automatic that things will just fall into place. There was found to be some teething problems. And therefore, it took us quite a while. But as a ministry and as a government, we want to assure the county government that we support and we believe in devolution. That was my brief when I came in as a minister myself, and it's a government brief. The president is supporting devolution and has given us that brief, that all of us as ministers in his government must work towards ensuring devolution works. Having understood that, then it is up to now our various ministries to up their game to ensure that issues of devolution really works in our various sectors. In the area of agriculture, as I mentioned, intergovernmental unit has been put in place. And to prove that, the management, even the funding and everything of that unit is done by the ministry. What I would want to encourage my brothers from the county is that let us staff it. As it is now, it is staffed by only ministry staff. We need participation from the county government, from the COG, second staff to that secretariat, so that we can work more harmoniously. I know there's a lot of harmony in working. When I came in, we had a very successful meeting with the COG, of which the chairman of COG himself took part. And there is a lot of hope, as Mbakati had said, in the area of agriculture. Issues of funding. Yes, we had hit about 5% in terms of our allocations. But we really need to appreciate the issue of devolution, because part of the resources were now going into the county level. And therefore, what we need to take into account is what the counties are going to invest in agriculture and what the national government is supposed to invest in agriculture. So investment in agriculture, which will form the declaration which our heads of state signed to make, or to which committed to 10% investment in agriculture, should in this circumstance now come from both sides, the national government and the county government. And therefore, we would want, and this is what we are seeing, and Mbakati has elaborated it, that investments at the county level to the area of agriculture is really very, very low. As far as policy issues is concerned, we as government have realized we need to collapse all the policies which we had come up with, and we have done that. We have actually completed one overhacking policy, the agriculture, livestock and fisheries policy, which is now ready for to be moved to cabinet, and then it will come to parliament. We believe with that policy now, we will cascade it and have the county government come up with strategies to implement the policy. The beautiful thing is that this policy was consultative in nature, and the county governments made a major contribution towards it. So actually, we are making progress as far as policy is concerned. We pride ourselves in agriculture as the highly devolved sector. We have devolved almost everything which you were supposed to devolve. What we want to do is to increase interaction between the national government and the county governments so that extension works. because what we are seeing now is that we have challenges in the areas of extension, in the areas of capacity building. I know we devolved agricultural training colleges, so we would want to see those colleges still do the work which was intended to do, not to convert them into doing other things. And this will only work if we interact together. Going forward, you will be seeing the Ministry of Agriculture inviting more county executives and governors so that we can agree on ways of moving this sector forward. Otherwise, as a government, as a ministry, we want to move agriculture forward together with the county governments. We know our role is at policy level, we know implementation is happening at the county level, but the two has to work together to ensure that we transfer the policies, the technologies, and everything else from the national government to be implemented at the county level. With that, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you and wish this session